Raina? Raina? Why? Where? Heaven's child! Are you out in the night air instead of in your bed? You'll catch your death! Luca told me you were asleep.
Oh, I sent her away. I wanted to be alone. Oh, the stars are so beautiful. What is the matter?
Such news! There's been a battle. A great battle at Sleep Nitsa. A victory. Oh, and it was won by Sergius.
No! Oh, mother, mother! Is father safe?
Of course! He sends me the news. Sergius is the hero of the hour, the idol of the regiment.
Oh, well, tell me, mother, mother, mother!
You can't guess how splendid it is. A cavalry charge! Think of that! He defied our Russian commanders, acted without orders, led a charge on his own responsibility, headed it himself, was the first man to sweep through their guns. Oh, can't you see it, Raina? Our gallant, splendid Bulgarians with their swords and eyes flashing, thundering down like an avalanche and scattering the wretched Serbs and their dandified Austrian officers like chaff. And you? You kept Sergius waiting a year before you would be betrothed to him. Oh, if you had one drop of Bulgarian blood in your veins, you will worship him when he comes home.
What will he care for my poor little worship after an acclamation of a whole army of heroes? But no matter. I am so happy today, so proud. It proves that all our ideas were real after all.
Our ideas real? What do you mean?
Our ideas of what Sergius would do. Our patriotism. Our heroic ideals. I sometimes used to doubt whether they were anything but dreams. Now what faithless little creatures girls are! When I buckled on Sergius's sword, he looked so noble. It was treason for me to think of disillusion or humiliation or failure. And yet... Promise me you won't tell him.
Oh, don't ask me for promises until I know what I'm promising.
Well, it came into my head just as he was holding me in his arms and looking into my eyes that perhaps we only had these heroic ideas because we were so fond of reading Byron and Pushkin and because we were so delighted with the opera that season at Bucharest. Real life is so seldom like that. Indeed, never. As far as I knew it then. Oh, to think, Mother, I doubted him! I wondered whether all his heroic qualities and soldiership might not prove mere imagination when held up into real battle. I feared he might cut a poor figure there next to all the clever officers of the Tsar's court.
A poor figure? Shame on you! The Serbs have Austrian officers who are just as clever as the Russians. But we have beaten them in every battle for all that.
Yes. He's only a prosaic little coward. Oh, to think that it was all so true! That Sergius is just as splendid and noble as he looks! Oh, that the world really is a glorious world for women who can see its glory and men who can act its romance! Oh, what happiness! What unspeakable fulfillment!
If you please, madam, all of the windows are to be closed and the shutters made fast. They say there may be shooting in the streets. The Serbs are being chased right back through the pass, and they say they may run into town. Our cavalry will be after them, and our people will be ready for them. You may be sure now they're running away. I must see that everything is made safe downstairs.
Why must our people be so cruel? What glory is there in killing wretched fugitives?
Cruel? Do you suppose they would hesitate to kill you? Or worse?
Leave the shutters open, Luca, so that I may just close them if I hear any noise.
Oh, no, dear, you must keep them fastened. You would be sure to drop off to sleep and leave them open. Make them fast, Luca.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't be anxious about me. The moment I hear a shot, I shall blow out the candles and curl myself up in bed with my ears well covered.
Quite the wisest thing you could do, my love. Good night.
Good night. Wish me joy. Tonight is the happiest night of my life. Only there were no fugitives.
Go to bed, dear, and don't think of them. If you would like the shutters open, just give them a push. One of them ought to be bolted at the bottom, but the bolt is gone.
Yes. Thank you, Luca, but we must must do as we are told. Good night. I will never be unworthy of you anymore, my soul's hero. Never, never, never.
Excuse my disturbing you, but you recognize my uniform. Sir, if I'm caught, I shall be killed. Do you understand that?
Yes.
Well, I don't intend to get killed if I can help it. Do you understand that?
I suppose not. Some soldiers I know are afraid to die.
All of them, dear lady, all of them, believe me. It is our duty to stay alive as long as we can. Now remember, if you raise your voice...
You will shoot me! How do you know I am afraid to die?
Suppose I don't shoot you. What will happen then? A lot of your men will burst into this pretty room of yours and slaughter me here like a pig. For I shall fight like a demon. They shan't get me in the street to amuse themselves with. Are you prepared to receive that sort of company in your present undress?
Oh!
Hardly presentable, huh?
Wait, stop!
Where are you going?
Only to get my cloak.
A good idea. I'll keep the cloak. And you'll take care that no one sees you without it. This is a better weapon than the revolver, huh?
It is not the weapon of a gentleman!
It's good enough for a man with only you to stand between him and death. Do you hear? If you're going to bring those blackguards in on me, you shall receive them as warning.
Thank you.
use, dear. I'm done for. Quick, wrap yourself up. They're coming.
Thank you.
Don't mention it.
What will you do?
I'm the first man in, we'll find out. Stay out of the way and don't look. It won't last long, but it will not be nice.
I'll help you. I'll save you.
You can't.
I can. Here, quick, behind the curtains.
There's just half a chance if you keep your head.
Shh.
Oh, remember!
Yes?
9 soldiers out of 10 are born fools. If they find me, I promise you'll fight. The devil of a fight.
I
I'm sorry. I've eaten them all except these.
Oh, oh, you're an angel!
Only the pistol missed fire, that's all.
Indeed. Would you know him again if you saw him?
Shall I ever forget him?
This is the gentleman, the patriot and hero to whom I am betrothed!
Oh, I'm really very sorry.
Was it fair to leave me on?
Yes, that's Don Quixote.
No doubt about it.
Why do you laugh?
I didn't laugh, I assure you. At least I didn't mean to. I'm sorry, it's just that when I think of him charging the windmills,
imagining he was doing the finest thing!
Give me back the portrait, sir!
Oh, of course, certainly. I'm really very sorry. Perhaps I'm quite wrong, you know. No doubt I am. Most likely he had gotten wind of the cartridge business somehow and knew it was a safe job.
That is to say, he is a pretender and a coward. You did not dare say that before.
It's no use! Dear young lady, I just can't make you see it from the professional point of view.
All the better for you. How? You are my enemy. And you are at my mercy. What would I do if I were a professional soldier?
True. Dear young lady, you are always right. I know how good you've been to me. To my last hour, I shall remember those three chocolate creams. It was unsoldierly, but it was angelic.
Yes! Thank you! And now I will do a soldierly thing! You cannot stay here after what you have just said about my future husband, but I will go out into the balcony and see whether it is safe for you to climb out.
Stop, wait! I can't! Oh, the very thought of it makes me giddy. I came up with fast enough with death behind me, but to face it now, in cold blood. Oh, it's no use. I'm done for. I give up. Sound the alarm.
Come, don't be disheartened. You are a poor soldier. A chocolate cream soldier. Come, cheer up! It takes less courage to climb down than to face capture. Remember that.
No. Capture only means death.
And death is sleep. Sleep, undisturbed sleep.
Climbing down that water pipe means doing something. Thinking, exerting myself.
Death 10 times over first.
Are you really as sleepy as that?
I have not had 2 hours of undisturbed sleep since I joined. I haven't closed my eyes in over 48 hours.
What am I to do with you?
Of course, I must do something. You see, sleep or no sleep, tired or not, you can always do a thing when you know it must be done. Well, that water pipe must be got down. Do you hear that? You chocolate cream soldier, you?
But if you fall?
Well, then I shall sleep as if the stones were a feather bed. Goodbye.
Stop! They'll kill you!
Never mind. This sort of thing is all my day's work. I'm bound to take my chance. Now do what I say. Put out the lights so that they shan't see me when I open the doors. And stay away from the window whenever you do. If they see me, they are sure to have a shot at me.
They are sure to see you. It's bright moonlight. I'll save you. Oh, how can you be so indifferent? You want me to save you, don't you?
I really don't want to be troublesome. I'm not indifferent, dear young lady, but how is it to be done?
Come away from the window. Please! Now, listen. You must trust my hospitality. county. You do not yet know whose house you are in. I am a Petkoff.
Pet what?
I mean that I am from the family of Petkoffs, the richest and best known in our country.
The Petkoffs! To be sure. How silly of me.
You know you have never heard of us until quite this very moment. How can you stoop to pretend?
But forgive me, please! The change of subject was too much!
I'm sorry. I forgot. I might make you cry. Now listen! You must know my father holds the highest command of any officer in our army. He is a major.
A major? Bless me, think of that.
You show great ignorance in thinking that it was necessary to climb off our balcony because ours is the only private house with two rows of windows. We have stairs inside you can go up and down by.
Stairs! How grand! You live in great luxury, dear young lady.
Do you know what a library is?
A library? A room full of books?
Yes! We have one. The only one in Bulgaria.
Actually, a real library. I should like to see that.
Well, I tell you these things to show you that you are not in the house of ignorant country folk who would kill you the moment they saw your Serbian uniform, but among civilized people. We go to Bucharest every year for the opera season, and I have spent a whole month in Vienna.
I saw that, dear young lady. I saw that once you knew the world.
Do you know the opera of Ernani?
Oh, is that the one with...
From his foes, just as you are tonight. Takes refuge in the house of his bitterest enemy. The old Castilian noble. The noble refuses to give him up. His guest is sacred to him.
Have your people got that notion?
My mother and I understand that a notion, as you call it. And if instead of threatening me with your pistol as you did, you had simply thrown yourself a fugitive on our hospitality, you would have been as safe as in your father's house.
Quite sure.
It is useless to try to make you understand.
Don't be angry with me, dear young lady. Think how awkward it would be if there was any mistake. You see, my father is a very hospitable man. He keeps 6 hotels. But I couldn't trust him as far as that. Say,
what about your father?
He's away at Sliednica, fighting for our country. I answer for your safety. Here's my hand in pledge. Will that reassure you?
Better not touch my hand, dear young lady. I must have a wash first.
That is very nice of you. I see that you are a gentleman.
Huh?
You must not be surprised. Bulgarians of really good standing. People in our position wash their hands nearly every day. So you see why I would appreciate your delicacy. You may take my hand.
Thanks, gracious lady. I feel safe at last. And now, if you wouldn't mind breaking the news to your mother, I would not like to stay secretly than longer as necessary.
As long as you promise to keep perfectly still whilst I'm away.
Certainly.
Oh!
You are not falling asleep, are you? Wake up! Wake up! You are falling asleep!
Falling asleep?
No. I was only thinking. I'm wide awake.
Will you please stand up whilst I'm away? All the time, mind.
Certainly. You may depend on me.
Sleep. Sleep. Sleep.
Yes. Danger.
Where is danger? I must find it.
Time, Luca. Mend your manners. I know the mistress, and though she is so grand, she never dreams a servant would dare be disrespectful to her. If she once suspects that you are defying her, out you go.
I do defy her. I will defy her. What do I care for her?
If you quarrel with the family, I can never marry you. It is the same as if you had quarreled with me.
You take her part and me, do you?
I shall always be dependent on the goodwill of the family. When I leave my station and start a shop in Sophia, their custom will be half my capital. Their bad word would ruin me.
You have no spirit. I should like to catch them say a word against me.
I should have expected more sense from you, Luca. But you're young. You're young.
Yes, and you like me the better for it, don't you? But I know some family secrets they wouldn't care to have told, young as I am. Let them quarrel with me if they dare.
Do you know what they would do if they heard you speak like that?
What could they do?
Discharge you for untruthfulness. Who would believe another story you told after that? Who would give you another station? Who in this house would dare be seen speaking to you again? How long would your father be left on that little farm of his? Child, you don't know the power such high people have over the likes of you and me when we try to rise out of poverty against them. Look at me. 10 years in their service. Do you think I know no secrets? I know things about the mistress that she wouldn't have the master know for 1,000 levas. I know things about him that she would let him hear the end of for months if I was to babble them to her. I know things about Miss Raina that would break off her match with Sergius if I was...
How do you know? I never told you!
So that's your little secret. Oh, I thought it might be something like that. Well, you take my advice and make the mistress feel that no matter what you know or... don't know. She can count on you to hold your tongue and serve the family faithfully. That's what they like, and it's how you will make the most out of them.
You have the soul of a servant, Nicola.
Yes, that is the secret of success in service.
Oh! Oh, oh!
Master, back from the war!
My word for it, Luca, the war is over. Off with you. Go and fetch some coffee.
Have you brought me some cognac?
Here, sir.
That's right.
brought you fresh coffee.
Yes, Luke has been looking after me. The war's over. The treaty was signed 3 days ago in Bucharest, and the decree for our army to demobilize was issued yesterday.
Paul, have the Austrians forced you to make peace?
My dear, they didn't consult me. What could I do? But, of course, we saw to it that the treaty was an honorable one. It declares peace.
Peace.
But not friendly relations. Remember that. They wanted to put that in, but I insisted on it being struck out. What more can I do?
You could have annexed Serbia and made Prince Alexander Emperor of the Balkans. That's what I would have done.
I don't doubt that in the least, my dear. But I should have to subdue the whole Austrian Empire first. And that would have kept me too long away from you. I missed you greatly. And how have you been, my dear?
The usual sore throats, that's all.
That comes from washing your neck every day. I've often told you so.
Nonsense, Paul.
I don't believe in going too far with these modern customs. All this washing can be good for your health. It's not natural. There was an Englishman in Philippopolis who used to wet himself all over with cold water every morning when he got up. Disgusting! It all comes from the English. Their climate makes them so dirty that they have to be perpetually washing themselves. And look at my father. He lived to be 98, healthiest man in Bulgaria. About a bath a day in his life. I don't mind a good wash once a week to keep up my position, but once a day is taking the thing to a ridiculous extreme.
You are a barbarian at heart still, Paul. I hope you behaved yourself before all those Russian officers.
I did my best. I took care to let them know that we have a library.
But you didn't tell them we had an electric bell in it. I've had one put up.
What's an electric bell?
You touch a button, something tinkles in the kitchen, and Nikola comes up.
Why not shout for him?
Civilized people don't shout for their servants. Oh, I've learned that while you were away.
Well, I'll tell you something I've learned too. Civilized people don't hang out their washings to dry where visitors can see them. So you'd better have all that, but somewhere else.
That's absurd, Paul. I don't think really refined people notice such things.
Yates, Nikola!
There's Sergius. Nikola!
Oh, don't shout, Paul. He's nice.
Bosh. Nikola! Yes, Major.
Are you deaf?
Don't you hear Major Saranov knocking? Bring him on this way.
Yes, sir.
You must talk to him, my dear. Until Raina takes him off our hands. He bores my life out with our not promoting him. Over my head. If you please.
Well, he certainly ought to be promoted if he's marrying Raina. Besides, the country should insist on having at least one native general.
Yes, so that he can throw away whole brigades instead of regiments.
It's no use, my dear.
He hasn't the slightest chance of promotion until we're quite sure that this peace will be a lasting one.
Major Sergius Serrano.
Here already, Sergius. Glad to see you.
My dear Sergius.
My dear mother. If I may call you so.
Mother-in-law, Sergius. Mother-in-law. Sit down and have some coffee.
Thank you. None for me.
You look superb, Sergius. The campaign has improved you. We're all wild about you. We're all mad with enthusiasm about that magnificent cavalry charge.
Madam, it was the cradle and the grave of my military reputation.
How so?
I won the battle the wrong way, when our worthy Russian generals were losing it the right way. In short, I upset their plans and wounded their self-esteem. Two Cossack colonels had their regiments rooted on the most correct principles of scientific warfare. Two major generals were killed strictly according to military etiquette. The two major generals are now colonels, and I am still a simple major.
Oh, you shall not remain so, Sergius. The women are on your side, and they will see that justice.
It is too late. I've waited only for the peace to send in my resignation.
Your resignation?
Oh, you must withdraw it.
I never withdraw.
Now, who could have supposed that you were going to do such a thing?
Everyone that knew me. But enough of myself and my affairs. How is Raina? And where is Raina?
Raina is here!
Pretty, isn't it? She always appears at the right moment.
Yes, she listens for it. It's an abominable habit.
Oh, dear father, welcome home!
Oh, my little pet girl!
And so, you are no longer a soldier, Sergius?
I am no longer a soldier. Soldiering, my dear madam, is the coward's art of attacking mercilessly when you are strong and keeping out of harm's way when you are weak. That is the whole secret to successful fighting. Get your enemy at a disadvantage and never, on any account, fight him on equal terms.
They wouldn't let us make a fair stand-up fight of it. However, I suppose soldiering is a trade like any other trade.
Precisely. But I have no ambition to shine as a tradesman, so I have taken the advice of that badman of a captain who helped to settle the exchange of prisoners at Faroe and given it up.
What? That Swiss fellow? Mm. Oh, Sergius, I've often thought of that exchange since. He overreached us about those horses.
Of course he overreached us. His father was a hotel and livery stable keeper, and he owed his first step to his knowledge of horse dealing. He was a soldier. Every inch a soldier. If only I had bought the horses for my regiment instead of foolishly leading it into danger, I should have been a field marshal now.
A Swiss? What was he doing in the Serbian army?
A volunteer, of course. Keen on picking up his profession. We shouldn't have been able to begin fighting if these foreigners hadn't shown us how to do it. We knew nothing about it. Neither did the Serbs. Egad, there'd have been one war without them.
Are there many Swiss officers in the Serbian army?
No, all Austrians. Just as all our officers were Russians. This was the only Swiss I came across. I'll never trust a Swiss again. He humbugged us into giving up 50 able-bodied men for 200 worn-out charges. They weren't even edible.
We were two children in the hands of that consummate soldier, Major. Simply two innocent little children.
What was he like?
Raina, what a silly question.
He was like commercial travelers in uniform. Bourgeois to his boots.
Sergius, tell Catherine that queer story his friend told us about how he escaped after Srebrenica. You remember, about him being hit by two women.
Oh, yes. Quite a romance. He was serving in the very battery I so unprofessionally charged. Being a thorough soldier, he ran away with the rest of them with our cavalry at his heels. To escape their sabers, he climbed the water pipe of a young Bulgarian lady. The young lady was very enchanted by his manners, and she then called in her mother lest her conduct should appear unmaidenly. The old lady was equally fascinated by his manners, and he was sent on his way in the morning, disguised in an old coat belonging to the master of the house who was away at war.
Your life at the camp has made you coarse, Sergius. I did not think you would repeat such a story before me.
She is right, Sergius. If such women exist, we should be spared the knowledge of them.
Oh, nonsense.
What does it matter?
No, Petkov. I was wrong. I have behaved abominably. I beg your pardon, Raina. And you too, madam. The glimpses I've had of the seamy side of life these last few months have made me cynical. But I should not have brought my cynicism here, least of all into your presence right now.
Stop and nonsense, Sergius! That's quite enough fuss about nothing. A soldier's daughter should be able to stand up without flinching to a little strong conversation. Come, it's time for us to get to business. We have to figure out how these three regiments are to get back to Philippopolis. There's no forage for them on the Sofia route. Come along.
Can't you spare Sergius for a few moments? Raina has hardly seen him yet. Perhaps I could help you settle about the regiment.
My dear madam, impossible. You are
No. You stay here. There's no hurry. I have a word or two to say to Paul. Now, dear, come see the electric bell.
Oh, very well, very well.
Am I forgiven?
My hero, my king!
My queen.
Oh, how I have envied you, Sergius! You have been out in the real world, on the field of battle, able to prove yourself there worthy of any woman in the world! Whilst I have had to sit at home, inactive, dreaming, useless, doing nothing that could give me the right to call myself worthy of any man.
Dearest, all my deeds have been yours. You inspired me. I've gone through this war like a knight in a tournament with his lady looking down at him.
And you have never been absent from my thoughts for a moment. Sergius, I think we too have found the higher love. And I think of you. I think I could do no base deed or think an ignoble thought.
My lady and my saint.
My lord and my
Shh. Let me be the worshipper, dear. You little know how unworthy even the best man is of a girl's pure passion.
I trust you. I love you. You will never disappoint me, Sergius. I cannot pretend to talk indifferently before her. My heart is too full.
Let me go get my hat,
and then we can go out until lunchtime.
Wouldn't you like that?
Be quick, dear. If you are away 5 minutes, it would seem 5 hours. Luca, do you know what the higher love is?
No, sir.
Very fatiguing thing to keep up for any length of time, Luca. One feels the need for some relief.
Perhaps you would like some coffee, sir.
Thank you, Luca.
Sir, you know I didn't mean that. I'm surprised at you.
I'm surprised at myself, Luca. What would Sergius, the hero of Slivnica, say if he saw me now? What would Sergius, the apostle of the higher love, say if he saw me now? What would the half dozen other Sergiuses who keep popping in and out of this handsome figure of mine say if they caught us here? You consider my figure handsome, Luca?
Let me go, sir, or I shall be disgraced. Will you let go?
No.
Then stand back where we can't be seen. Have you no common sense?
That's reasonable.
I may have been seen from the windows. Miss Raina is sure to be spying about after me.
Take care, Luca. I may be worthless enough to betray the higher love, but do not you insult him.
Not for the world, sir, I'm sure. May I go on with my work, please?
You are a provoking little witch, Luca. If you were in love with me, would you spy out of windows on me?
Well, you see, sir, since you say you are half a dozen different gentlemen all at once, I should have a great deal to look after.
Witty as well as pretty.
No, I do not want your kisses. Gentlefolk are all alike, you making love to me behind Miss Raina's back, and she doing the same behind yours.
Luca!
It shows how little you really care.
If our conversation is to continue, Luca, you would please remember that a gentleman does not discuss the conduct of the lady he is engaged to with her maid.
It is so hard to know what a gentleman considers right. I thought from your trying to kiss me, you had given up being so particular.
Devil. Devil!
I'd expect one of the six of you is very like me, sir, though I am only Miss Raina's maid.
Which of the six is the real man? That is the question that torments me. One of them is a hero, another a humbug, another a buffoon, another perhaps a bit of a blackguard, and one, at least, is a coward, jealous like all cowards. Luca.
Yes?
Who is my rival?
You shall never get that out of me for love or money.
Why?
Never mind why. Besides, you would tell I told you and I should lose my place.
No! On the honor of a man capable of behaving as I have been behaving for the past 5 minutes, who is he?
I don't know. I never saw him. I only heard his voice through the door of her room.
Damnation, how dare you?
Oh, I mean no harm. You've no right to take up my words like that. The mistress knows all about it, and I tell you that if that gentleman ever comes here again, Miss Raina is sure to marry him, whether he likes it or not. I know the difference between the sort of manner you and she put on before one another and the real manner.
Now listen, you to me.
Not so tight, you're hurting me.
That doesn't matter. You have stained my honor by making me a party to your eavesdropping, and you have betrayed your mistress.
Please.
That shows that you are an abominable little clod of common clay with the soul of a servant.
You know how to hurt with your tongue as well as with your hands, but I don't care. Now I've found that whatever clay I'm made of, you're made of the same. As for her, she's a liar. And her fine hairs are a cheat, and I am worth six of her.
Luca, a gentleman does not harm a lady under any circumstances. I beg your pardon.
That sort of apology may satisfy a lady. Of what use is it to a servant?
Oh, you wish to be paid for the hurt.
No! I want my hurt made well.
How? Never.
What's the matter? Were you flirting with Luca?
No! No! How can you think such a joke?
Pardon me, dear. It was but a jest. I am so happy today.
I'm sorry to disturb you, children, but Paul is distracted over those three regiments. He doesn't know how to send them to Philippopolis, and he objects to every suggestion of mine. You must go and help him, Sergius. He's in the library.
But we are just going for a walk.
I'll be quick, dear. I will be but 5 minutes.
I'll be waiting in full view of the library windows. Be sure to draw Father's attention to me. If you are gone a moment longer than 5 minutes, I shall come in and fetch you, regiments or no regiments.
Very well.
The effect of the peace on my husband has been to make him feel like a lion.
box of his prey. If he discovers our secret, he will never forgive me. My daughter's life will hardly be safe. Will you, like the kind and chivalrous gentleman and soldier you are, please leave this house before they find you here?
At once. Gracious lady, I only came to thank you and return the coat you lent me. If you will allow me to take it out of my bag and leave it with your servant.
Oh, no, you must not think of going that way. This is the shortest way out. Many thanks. So glad to have been of service to you. Goodbye.
Oh, but my bag.
It shall be sent on. You will leave me your address.
True. Allow me.
Sure I can't help you in any way, Bluntschli.
Quite sure, thank you. Saranoff and I will manage it.
Yes, we'll manage it. He finds out what to do, draws up the orders, and then I sign them. Division of labor. Another one? Thank you. This hand is more accustomed to the sword than to the pen.
It is very good of you, Bluntschli. It is indeed to let yourself be put upon in this way. Now, are you quite sure I can do nothing?
You can stop interrupting, Paul.
Oh. Quite right, love. Quite right. You haven't been campaigning, Catherine. You don't know how nice it is to sit here after a good lunch with nothing to do but enjoy ourselves. There's just one thing I want to make me thoroughly comfortable.
What is that?
My old coat! I'm not at home in this one! I feel as if I were on parade.
My dear Paul, how absurd you are about that old coat! I'm sure it's hanging in the blue closet where you left it.
My dear Catherine, I tell you, I've looked there! Am I to believe my own eyes or not? What are you showing off that bell for? My dear, if you think the obstinacy of your sex can make a coat out of two old dressing gowns of Ryan's, one waterproof, and my Macintosh, you're mistaken. That is exactly what the blue closet contains at present.
Nicola, go to the blue closet and fetch your master's old coat, the braided one he wears in the house.
Yes, madam.
Catherine?
Yes, Paul.
I bet you any piece of jewelry you like to order from Sophia against the week's housekeeping money that the coat isn't there.
Done, Paul.
Come! Here's an opportunity for some sport. Oh, bet on it. Bluntschli, I'll give you 6-1.
It would be robbing you, Major. Madam is sure to be right.
Bravo, Switzerland. Major, I bet my best charger against an errant bear for Raina that Nicola finds the coat in the blue closet.
Your best
charger.
Don't
be foolish, Paul. Arabian mare costs 50,000 lava.
Really, Mother? If you are going to take the jewelry, I don't see why you should grudge me my arrow.
Oh, where was it?
Hanging in the blue closet, madam.
Well, I am dead. I could have sworn it wasn't there. Age is beginning to tell on me. I'm having hallucinations. Here, how does it change? Excuse me, Bluntschli. Now remember, I didn't take that bet of yours, Sergius. So you'd better give Raina that Arab steed yourself, since you've roused her expectations. Hey, Raina! She's dreaming, as usual.
Assuredly, she shall not be the loser.
So much the better for her. I shan't come off so cheaply.
Now I feel at home at last.
That's the last order.
What? Finished?
Finished?
Well, haven't you anything for me to sign?
Not necessary. His signature will do.
Well, then I think we've done a thundering good day's work, gentlemen. Could I do anything more?
You had better both see the fellows that are to take these. Pack them off at once and show them that I've marked on the orders the time they should hand them in by. Tell them that if they stop to drink or tell stories, that if they're even 5 minutes late, they'll have the skin taken off their backs.
I'll say so. And if one of them is man enough to spit in my face for insulting him, I'll buy his discharge and give him a pension. Ah!
Just see that he talks to them properly, Major, will you?
Quite right, Bluntschli. Quite right. I'll see to it. Oh, by the by, Catherine, you may as well come too. They'll be far more frightened of you than of me.
I dare say I had better. You would only splutter at them.
What an army! They make cannons out of cherry trees, and they send their wives to keep discipline.
You look ever so much nicer than before. What have you done to yourself?
Washed, brushed, good night's sleep and rest, that's all.
And did you get back safely the next morning?
Quite. Thanks.
Were they angry with you from running away from Seraphius's charge?
No, they were glad, because they'd all just run away themselves.
Must have made quite a story. Me and my group.
Capital story, but I only told it to one of them. A particular friend.
On whose discretion you could absolutely rely?
Absolutely.
He told it all to my father and Sergius the morning they exchanged the prisoners.
No. You don't mean that, do you?
I most certainly do. But what they don't know is that it was in this house that you took refuge. If Sergius knew, he would surely challenge you and kill you in a duel.
Bless me! And don't tell him.
Please be serious, Captain Bluntschli. Do you not know what it is for me to deceive him? I want to be quite perfect with Sergius. No meanness, no smallness, no deceit. My relation to him is the one truly noble and beautiful part of my life. I hope you can understand that.
You mean that you wouldn't want him to find out the story about the ice pudding, what?
know.
Don't talk of it in that flippant way. I lied. I know it. But I did it to save your life. He would have killed you. That was the second time I ever uttered a falsehood. Do you remember the first?
No, was I present?
Yes. And I told the officer that was searching for you that you were not present.
True, I should have remembered it.
It's only natural that you should forget it first. It costs you nothing. It costs me a lie. A lie!
Don't let this worry you, dear young lady. Remember, I am a soldier. And what are the two things that happen to a soldier so often that he comes to think nothing of them? One is hearing people tell lies. And the other is getting his life saved in all sorts of ways by all sorts of people.
And so he becomes a creature incapable of faith and gratitude?
Do you like gratitude? I don't. If pity is akin to love, gratitude is akin to the other thing.
Gratitude? If you are incapable of gratitude, you are incapable of any noble sentiment. Even animals are grateful. Oh, I see what you think of me. You were not surprised to hear me lie.
No.
It was something I probably do every day, every hour. That is how men think of women.
There's reason in everything, dear young lady. You said yourself you had only told two lies in your whole life. Isn't that a rather short allowance? I'm quite a straightforward man myself, but it wouldn't last me a whole morning.
Do you know, sir, that you are insulting me?
I can't help it. When you strike that noble attitude and speak in that thrilling voice, I admire you. I find it hard to believe a single word you say.
Captain Bluntly!
Yes?
Do you mean what you said just now? Do you know what you said just now?
I do.
Why? How did you find me out?
Instinct, dear young lady, instinct. Experience of the world.
You know, you are the first man I ever met who did not take me seriously.
You mean, don't you, that I'm the first man to ever take you quite seriously?
Yes. Well, I suppose I do mean that. How strange it is to be talked to in such a way. You know, I've always gone on like that.
Oh, yeah, you mean,
I mean the noble attitude and the thrilling voice. I did it when I was a tiny child to my nurse. She believed in it. I do it before my parents. They believe in it. I do it before Sergius. He believes in it.
Yes, he is a little in that line himself, isn't he?
Oh, do you think so?
You know him better than I do.
Oh, I thought that. No matter. I suppose now that you've found me out, you despise me.
No. No, no, my dear young lady. 1,000 times, no. It's part of your youth. Part of your charm. I'm just like all the rest of them. The nurse, your parents, Sergius. I'm your infatuated admirer.
Really?
Hand out characters. Really and truly.
But what did you think of me for giving you my portrait?
Your portrait? You never gave me your portrait.
You mean to say you never got it?
No. When did you send it to me?
I did not send it to you! I put it in the pocket of that coat.
Oh! I never found it!
It must be there still!
There still! For my mother to find the first time you put his hand in that pocket! Oh, how could you be so stupid?
Listen, Bat! I suppose it's only a photograph. Tell him he put it there himself.
Yes. Oh, yes, that is so clever, isn't it? Oh, whatever shall I do?
Oh. I see. You wrote something in it, didn't you? That was rash.
I've done such a thing for you. Who cares no more except to laugh at me? Oh! Are you sure no one has touched it?
Can't be quite sure. I couldn't carry it about with me all the time. One can't carry much luggage during active service.
What did you do with it?
Well, when I got through to Perot, I had to put it in safekeeping somewhere. I thought of the railway cloakroom, but that's the surest place to get looted in modern warfare. So I pawned it.
Pawned it!
I know it doesn't sound nice, but it was sure the safest plan. I redeemed it the day before yesterday. Heaven only knows whether the pawnbroker cleared out the pockets or not.
You have a long shot to be mined. You think of things that would never come into a gentleman's head.
That's the Swiss national character, dear lady.
I wish I had never met you.
For you. The messenger's waiting.
Excuse me. The last postal delivery that reached me was 3 weeks ago. These are the subsequent accumulations. Four telegrams. A week old. Bad news.
Bad news?
My father's dead.
Oh! Very sad.
Yes. I shall have to start up for home in an hour. He has left a lot of big hotels to be looked after. Here's a whacking letter from the family solicitor. Oh, great heavens. 70? 200? 400? 4,000? 9,600? What am I to do with them all?
9,000 hotels?
Hotels? Nonsense. If you only knew it. That's too ridiculous. Excuse me. I must give my fellow orders about starting.
He has not much heart, that Swiss. Not a word of grief for his poor father.
Grief? A man who has done nothing but kill people for years? What does he care? What does any soldier care?
Major Saranov has been fighting too, and he has plenty of heart left. Oh, I thought you wouldn't be getting much feeling out of your soldier.
Ah, there you are, my girl. I've been trying all the afternoon to get a minute alone with you. Why, what fashion is that of wearing your sleeve?
My own fashion.
Indeed, if the mistress catches you, she'll talk to you.
Is that any reason why you should take it on yourself to talk to me?
Come, don't be so contrary with me. I have some good news for you. See? A 20 level bill. Sergius gave me that out of pure swagger. Oh, a fool and his money are soon parted. There's 10 levels more. The Swiss gave me that for backing up the mistress's and Miss Raina's lies about him this morning. He's no fool, he isn't that Swiss. You should have heard old Catherine downstairs this morning, as polite as you please to me, telling me not to mind the major for being a little impatient, after making a liar and a fool of me before them all. The 20 shall go to our savings, and the 10 to you to spend. If you will only talk to me to remind me I'm human, I do tire of being a servant occasionally.
Yes. Sell your manhood for 30 levas and buy me for 10. Keep your money. You were born to be a servant. I was not. When you open your shop, you will only be everybody's servant instead of somebody's servant.
Wait till you see. Oh, we shall have our evenings to ourselves, and I will be master in my own house. I promise you.
You shall never be master in mine.
You have a great ambition in you, Luca. Remember, if any luck ever comes to you, it was I that made a woman of you.
You?
Yes, me. Who was it that made you give up wearing pounds of false black hair and reddening your lips and cheeks like any other Bulgarian girl? I did. Who was it that got you to trim your nails and wash your hands and act fine and dainty like a nice Russian lady? Me. Did you hear that? Me. You know, I've often thought that if Raina were out of the way, and you were a little bit less of a fool, and Sergius a bit more of one, you would come to be my grandest customer, rather than my wife and costing me money.
I believe you would rather be my servant than my husband. You would make more out of me. Oh, I know that soul of yours.
Never you mind my soul, but listen to my advice. If you want to be a lady, your present behavior to me will never do unless when we're in private. It's too sharp and impudent. And impudence is a form of familiarity. It shows affection for me. Oh, and don't be high and mighty with me. You're like all country girls. You think it's genteel to treat a servant the way I would treat a stable boy? That's just your ignorance. And don't you forget it. Oh, don't be so ready to defy everybody. Act as if you've expected to get your way, not as if you've expected to be ordered about. The way to get on as a lady is the same as a servant. You've got to know your place. And you can count on me to know mine should you get promoted. Think it over, my girl. One servant should always stand by another.
Oh, I must behave in my own way. You take all of the courage out of me with your cold-blooded wisdom. Go and put those logs on the fire. That's the sort of thing you understand.
I'm not in the way of your work, I hope.
No, sir. Thank you kindly. I was simply up here talking to this foolish girl about her habit of running up to the library to look at the books. It's the worst of her education, sir. It gets her habits above her station. Now, tidy up the table, Luca, for the manger.
Me see. Is there a mark there? Does it hurt?
Yes.
Shall I cure it?
No. You may not cure it now.
Quite sure.
Don't trifle with me, please. An officer should not trifle with a servant.
That was no trifle, Luca.
Are you sorry?
I am never sorry.
Oh, I wish a man could be as unlike a woman as that. I wonder, are you really a brave man?
Yes. I am a brave man. My heart jumped like a woman's at the first shot, but in the charge, I found I was brave. Yes, that, at least, is real about me.
Did you find in the charge that the men whose fathers are poor like mine were any less brave than the men who are rich like you?
Not a bit. They all slashed and cursed and yelled like heroes. Pshaw, the courage to rage and kill is cheap. I have an English bull terrier who has as much of that sort of courage as the whole Bulgarian nation, and the Russian nation at its back. But he lets my groom thrash him all the same. That's your soldier all over. So no, Luca. Your poor men can cut throats, but they are afraid of their officers. They put up with insults and blows. They sit back and see one another punished like children, aye, and help to do it when they are ordered. And the officers, well, I am an officer. Give me the man who will defy to the death any power on earth or in heaven that sets itself up against his own will and conscience. He alone is the brave man.
How easy it is to talk. Men never seem to me to grow up. They all have schoolboys' ideas. You don't know what true courage is.
Indeed. I'm willing to be instructed.
Look at me. How much am I allowed to have my own will? I have to get your room ready for you, to sweep and dust, to fetch and carry. How could that degrade me if it did not degrade you to have it done for you? But if I were Empress of Russia, above everyone in the world, then, though according to you I could show no courage at all, you should see. You should see.
And what would you do, most noble empress?
I would marry the man that I love, which no queen in Europe has the courage to do. If I loved you, though you would be as far beneath me as I am beneath you, I would dare to be the equal of my inferior.
Would you dare as much if you felt the same for me? No. No, if you felt the beginnings of love for me, you would not let it grow. You would not dare. You would marry a rich man's daughter because you would be afraid of what other people would say of you.
No! By all the stars, it is not so. If I loved you and I were the Tsar himself, I would set you on the throne by my side. You know that I love another woman, and she is as high above you as the stars are above Earth, and you are jealous of her.
I have no reason to be. She will never marry you now. The gentleman I told you of has come back. She will marry the Swiss.
The Swiss?
A man worth 10 of you. And then you can come back to me, and I will refuse you. You are not good enough for me.
I will kill the Swiss, and afterwards I will do as I please with you.
The Swiss will kill you, perhaps. He has beaten you in love. He may beat you in war.
You think I believe that she, whose worst thoughts are higher than your best ones, is capable of trifling behind my back with another man?
Do you think that she would believe the Swiss now if he told her that I am in your arms?
Nation. Oh, damnation! Mockery! Mockery everywhere! Everything I think is mocked by everything I do. Coward, liar, fool! Shall I kill myself like a man or live and pretend to laugh at myself?
Remember, Luca, you belong to me.
What does that mean? An insult?
It means that I have had you here in my arms and may perhaps have you there again. Whether that is an insult, I neither know nor care. Take it as you please. But I will not be a coward and a trifler. If I choose to love you, I dare marry you in spite of all Bulgaria. If these hands ever touch you again, they shall touch my fine bride.
We shall see whether you dare keep your word. And take care. I will not wait long.
Yes, we shall see. And you shall wait my pleasure.
That's a remarkable looking young woman.
Captain Bluntschli. You have deceived me. You are my rival. I brook no rivals. At 6 o'clock, I shall be on the drilling ground on the Clisura Road, alone, on horseback, with my saber. Do you understand?
Oh, thank you! That's a cavalryman's proposal. If I go, I shall bring machine gun. There shall be no mistake about the cartridges this time.
Here, sir. In Bulgaria, we do not allow invitations of that kind to be trifled with.
Oh, pooh! Don't talk to me about Bulgaria! But fine, have it your own way. Bring your saber along, I will meet you.
Well said, Switzer. Shall I lend you my best horse?
No! Damn your horse! But thank you all the same, my dear fellow. I shall fight you on foot. Horseback is too dangerous. I don't want to kill you if I can help it.
Captain Bluntschli said, Sergius, you are going to fight? Why? Yeah, what for?
I don't know. He hasn't told me. Let's not interfere, dear young lady. No harm shall be done. I've often acted as sword instructor. He will be able to touch me, and I will not hurt him. For the sake of explanation, in the morning I will be off, and you will never see or hear of me again. You and he will then make it up, and live happily ever after.
Never said I wanted to see you again.
Ha! That is a confession.
What do you mean?
You love that man.
Sergius!
You make love to him behind my back just as you treat me as your affianced husband behind his. Actually, you knew our relations. It is for that I call you to account. Not for having received favors I never enjoyed.
Oh, stop! Rubbish, I have received no favors. Why, the young lady doesn't even know whether I'm married or not.
No! Are you?
You see the young lady's concern, Bluntschli. Denial is useless. You have received the favor of being received in her own room, late at night.
Yes, you blockhead! She received me with a pistol at her head. I would have blown her brains out if she'd uttered a cry.
Bluntschli!
Raina, is this true?
How dare you! How dare you!
Apologize, man, apologize.
I never apologize.
This is the doing of that friend of yours, Captain Bluntly. It is he who has spread this horrible rumor about me.
No, he's dead. Burnt alive.
Burnt alive?
Your fellow Shell set the timber on fire and burnt him with half a dozen other poor devils in the same predicament.
Oh. How horrible.
And how ridiculous. Oh, war, war, the dream of patriots and heroes. A fraud, Bluntschli, a hollow sham. Like love.
Like love? You dare say that before me!
Come, Saranoff, that matter is explained.
A hollow sham, I say. Bluntschli, would you have come back here if nothing had passed between you except at the muzzle of your pistol? Raina is mistaken about your friend. He was not my informant.
Who then? Luca? My maid? My servant? You were with her this afternoon! What god have I been worshipping? Do you know, I looked out the window this afternoon to have another sight of my hero. And I didn't understand what I saw then. I know now that you were making love to her.
You saw that?
Only too well.
Raina, our romance is shattered. Life's a farce.
You see, he's found himself out now.
Bluntschli, I have allowed you to call me a blockhead. You may now call me a coward as well. I refuse to fight you. Do you know why?
No, and it doesn't matter. I didn't ask for a reason when you cried on, and I don't ask for a reason now that you cry off. I'm a professional soldier. I fight when I have to, and I'm very glad to get out of it when I haven't. You're only an amateur. You think fighting is an amusement.
You shall hear the reason all the same. It takes two men. Real men. Men of heart, blood, and honor to make a genuine combat. I could no more fight with you than I could make love to an ugly woman. You've no magnetism. You're not a man. You're a machine.
Quite true. Quite true. I always was that sort of chap. I'm really very sorry.
Sure.
But now that you have found out that life isn't a farce but something quite sensible, what further obstacle is there to your happiness?
You are very solicitous about my happiness and his. Do you not remember his new love, Luca? It is not you he must fight with now, but his new rival, Nicola.
Rival?
Don't you know they're engaged?
Nicola? Are fresh abysses opening, Nicola?
How shocking! Sacrifice, isn't it? Such beauty, such modesty, wasted on a complacent servant man. Really, Sergius, you cannot stand by and allow such a thing. It would be unworthy of your chivalry.
Of the degree of provocation, my life was at stake.
My love was at stake. I am not ashamed.
Your love? Your curiosity, you mean.
My love. Stronger than anything you can feel. Even for your chocolate cream soldier.
What does that mean?
It means that
I remember. The ice pudding. A paltry taunt girl.
Excuse my shirt sleeves, gentlemen. Ryan, somebody has been wearing that coat of mine. Oh. Somebody who's worn it without care. It's all burst open at the sleeve. Your mother is mending it. I wish you'd make haste. I'll catch a cold. Anything the matter?
No!
Oh, no. Nothing. Nothing.
That's all right.
Anything the matter, Luca?
No, sir.
That's all right. Go and ask your mistress for my coat like a good girl, will you?
Which is it, Bluntschli?
Never mind whether it's heroism or baseness. Nikol is the ablest man I've met in Bulgaria. I'll make him manager of a hotel if he can speak French and German.
I have been insulted by everyone here. You set them the example. You owe me an apology.
It's no use.
He never apologizes.
Not to you, his equal and his enemy. To me, his poor servant. He would not refuse to apologize.
You are right. Forgive me.
I forgive you. That touch makes me your affianced wife.
Ah, I forgot about that.
You may withdraw if you like.
Withdraw? Never. You belong to me.
What does this mean?
Well, my dear, it appears that Sergius is going to marry Luca instead of Rhina. Don't blame me, I've nothing to do with it.
Marry Luca? Sergius, you are bound by your word to us.
Nothing binds me.
Soranov! Your hand. My congratulations. These heroics of yours have their practical side after all. Gracious lady, the best wishes of a good Republican.
Luca, you have been telling stories. I have done Rhina no harm.
Rhina?
I have a right to call her Rhina. She calls me Luca. I told Major Sergius she would never marry him if the Swiss gentleman came back.
Hello.
I thought you were fonder of your man, Sergius. You know best whether I was right.
What nonsense! I assure you, my dear Major, my dear Madam, the gracious lady simply saved my life. Nothing else. My heart and soul, she never cared two straws for me.
Look at the young lady and then look at me.
She who is rich, young, and beautiful, with her imagination full of fairy princes and noble natures, and cavalry charges, and goodness knows what else. And I, a commonplace Swiss soldier, a man who doesn't even know what a decent life is after 15 years of barracks and battles. A vagabond. A man who has spoiled all of his chances in life through an incurably romantic disposition.
Excuse me, Bluntschlies. What did you say had spoiled your chances in life?
An incurably romantic disposition. I ran away from home twice when I was a boy. I went into the army instead of into my father's business. I climbed the balcony of this house when any other man of sense would have dived into the nearest cellar. Came sneaking back to have another look at the gracious young lady who saved my life. When any other man of my age would have simply sent the coat back.
My coat!
Yes, that's the coat I need. Would have sent the coat back and gone quietly home. Do you suppose I'm the sort of fellow a young girl falls in love with? Why, look at our ages. I'm 34. I don't suppose the young lady is much over 17. All that adventure, which was life or death for me, was nothing but a schoolgirl's game to her. Chocolate creams and hide and seek. Oh, here is the proof. Now I tell you, would a young lady who took the affair seriously have given me this and written on it? Rhina, to her chocolate cream soldier. A souvenir.
That's what I was looking for.
How the deuce did it get there? I chose everything right, I hope. Gracious young lady.
I quite agree with the account of yourself. You are a romantic idiot. Next time, I hope you can tell the difference between a schoolgirl of 17 and a woman of 23.
Whoa, whoa, 23?
Bluntschlies, my one last belief is gone. Your sagacity is a fraud, like everything else. You have less sense than even I.
23! 23. Well, in that case, Major Petkoff, I beg to propose formally to be a suitor for your daughter's hand. In place of Major Soranov, retired.
You dare!
If you were 23 when you said those things to me this afternoon, I shall take them seriously.
I doubt, sir, whether you quite realize either my daughter's position or that of Major Sergius Saranoff's whose place you propose to take. The Petkoffs and the Saranoffs are known as the richest and most important families in the country. Our position is almost historical. We go back 20 years.
Oh, never mind that, Catherine. We should be most happy, Bluntschli, if it were a matter of position. But, hang it, you know, Raina is accustomed to a very comfortable establishment. Sergius keeps 20 horses.
What are we to do with 20 horses? We're not going to keep a circus.
My daughter, sir, is accustomed to a first-rate stable.
Really, Mother? You're making me ridiculous.
Well, if it's a question of establishment, here it goes. How many horses did you say?
20, noble Switzer.
I have 200. How many carriages have you?
3.
I have 70. Well, 24 of them will hold 12 on the side, besides 2 on the box, not counting the driver and the conductor.
How many tablecloths have you?
How the deuce do I know?
Have you 4,000?
No.
I have 9,600 pairs of sheets and blankets with 2,600 eiderdown quilts. I have 10,000 knives and forks and the same quantity of dessert spoons. I have 300 servants. I have 6 palatial establishments, besides 2 livery stables, a tea garden, and a private house. I have 4 medals for distinguished services. I have the standing of a gentleman and the ranking of an officer. I have 3 native languages. Show me any man in Bulgaria that can offer as much.
Are you the Emperor of Switzerland?
My rank is highest known in Switzerland. I'm a free citizen.
Well, since you are my daughter's first choice...
He's not.
I shall not say that's me. That costs me also.
Oh, I should be most happy. 200 horses.
What says the lady?
The lady says he can keep his tablecloths and his omnibuses. I am not here to be sold to the highest bidder.
I won't take that answer. I appeal to you as a beggar, a fugitive, and a starving man. You accepted me. You gave me your hand to kiss, your bed to sleep in, your roof to shelter me.
I did not give them to the Emperor of Switzerland.
That's just what I say. Tell us whom you did give them to.
To my chocolate cream soldier.
That'll do. Oh, time's up, Major. You have managed those regiments so well, you are sure to be asked to get rid of some of the infantry of the Tomok Division. Send them home by way of Long Palanca. Saranoff, do not get married until I come back. I shall be here punctually at 5 in the evening on Tuesday fortnight. Gracious ladies, good evening.